Welcome to my live chat. I'm so excited to see all of you guys or be in your presence and be going live. I can't actually see you, but I have a lot of your questions. And before I answer any of the questions, I have some really exciting news and a big, huge announcement. So if you guys are ready, I hope you're screaming and jumping down in your room right now because I'm about to tell you when my album is releasing. Are you guys ready? September 20th. There we go. Yay! I'm coming out with my third album on September 12th. I mean, shoot. September 20th, 2011. So it is very, very soon. Very excited. So I guess we'll get started right with the questions. Marie Jo MLH asks, what was it like shooting the video for Skyscraper? Shooting the video for Skyscraper was really emotional for me. I had to go to that place in my mind that I was in when I recorded the song. So it was very emotional, and it was a very intimate set. There wasn't very many people there. We took a plane with about like 15 people, and that was it. And we went to the middle of the desert and shot this music video with a crew of maybe 50 guys. So it was a pretty small shoot, and it was really cool. And it turns out to be, I mean, my favorite video that I've done, and hopefully you guys feel the same. I really, really enjoyed doing it, and it was like an emotional release for me. It was like therapy almost. So, yeah. At DD Lovato, an angel asks, that small red heart in the Skyscraper music video, is that little heart for us, or is it there to remind you of something? The heart in the video, to me, represented my own heart, and, you know, it's such a symbolic figure in the music video. It's made of glass, so your heart's very fragile. My heart's very fragile, and you can break down that shield in front of it, but at the end of the day, that heart is still going to be standing. And I thought, you know, what a beautiful way to interpret that, and such a great way, you know, to go along with the message of the song. So, you know, I think it was really cool that the heart was actually made of glass, and it never got broken, even though the shield exploded. So. At Lucy Loves Lovato asks, if you could meet anyone in the world dead or alive, who would it be and what would you say to them? I have a few people that I would meet. First off, I would love to have met Billie Holiday. I feel like I was her in my past life for some reason. I've just always related to her and her music. Her music is amazing. But most of all, her story is so incredible, and she's been just a huge inspiration to me, how strong she was in a time where, you know, it was so much more difficult for her back then than things are now, you know. Anyways, but yeah, I would have loved to have met her, and I really want to meet the Queen one day. It's not a lot of people get to meet the Queen, so I think that'd be pretty rad. At DD Lovato Rally asks, what is the best advice anyone has ever given you in your career that you carry with you to this day, or even about life? I love you. Aww. The best advice that has ever been given to me is basically to Selena's mom, Mandy, who's awesome and I love her to death. She told me, never believe the hype. And it's true. You can, in this industry, everyone hypes you up, and you go through periods of time where paparazzi is following you around and it's crazy. And, you know, everyone wants to be your friend and everyone wants to date you, and it's just weird. And it's this, all of this attention all at once, and you're doing so great and you're successful. But if you believe all of that, you know, it's an unrealistic amount of attention. And you can't believe it. You can't, you know, you can be proud of your music, and you can be proud of what you're doing and your work and the charities that you work for. But at the end of the day, if you don't believe the hype, you still are a normal person, and don't let it go to your head, basically. So I thought that was really cool, and that's always kind of stuck with me, and I love it. I think that's such a cool saying. So yeah, and of course, stay strong, which is my own motto. So I guess it's never been given to me, but for some reason, those two words really, really resonated with me, and I love them. They've helped them gotten through. That phrase has helped me got through so much. So, I love you, Demi asks. Can we be besties? From Yasmin from Spain. I thought we were already besties, so I'm offended. Lucy Loves Lovato asks, if I gave you an elephant, where would you hide it? In my pocket, duh. Where would you hide your elephant? At GagaMonster96 asks, have you bought all of Lady Gaga's albums? Which one is your favorite and why? Yes, I have bought, well, I bought the Fame album, and then I bought a recent one. And I don't know, this one's pretty good. This one's amazing. When you were making the music video for Skyscraper, what did you want people to get out of it? I just wanted people to be inspired. This was from Mari_902. I just wanted people to be inspired, and I wanted people to see, you know, I didn't want it to be this huge, glamorous music video, because at the end of the day, the song was so raw and so emotional, and I was very vulnerable when I shot it, so I wanted it to have that same feel. I wanted people to really relate to me and, you know, see the emotion, and I just wanted people to be inspired. Irulu asks, what instruments do you know how to play? I know how to play piano and guitar, and I know how to pretend to play the drums. Demi Lover 16 asks, oh, and Lover with a U, and yeah, that's really funny. I'm a very shy person, and I don't have many friends. What do you think is the best way to make friends is? I think the best way to make friends is to obviously be yourself, and it's okay to be shy. You know, I know a lot of people that wish that I was shy, but I'm not. And I can be really loud and really annoying, and my family can attest to that. At Didi Lovato, an angel asks, when you do your world tour, will you also tour South Africa also? Well, if I was to tour, I would announce it soon, and maybe, possibly, I'm in the works of putting together a tour, maybe, and maybe it would be all around the world. I don't know, I'm just saying. At Our Queen is Demi L asks, what was your first expression when you knew Skyscrapers was number one on iTunes? Well, when I went to bed the night before, earlier in the night, I had been like 184 on iTunes, and I was stoked. I was like, no way, it's already in the top 200 songs on iTunes. That's amazing. And then, like, a few hours later, it just slowly started going up, and I remember it being like 13 when I went to bed, and I was like, okay, that's incredible. That's like so unbelievable. This is awesome. And then I woke up the next morning, it was number 3, and shortly after, it went number 1, and I was like, unbelievable, this day could not get any better, and I was just on cloud 19. It was amazing. Buzz, with 3 Z's, 1, 2, 3, asks, what's your favorite nail polish? And I have to say that my favorite nail polish is one with glitter in it. So whether it's OPI or if it's Essie, I don't know, it's just, you know, whatever one has glitter in it. Paigey Poo asks, please say happy birthday, Paige. Happy birthday, Paige. Brent J asks, if you had to move to a deserted island, what 5 items would you bring with you? I would bring a lot of water, some food, my phone, an airplane with gas in it, and a pilot. And I'm hoping that the island has some sort of runway on it. So that people ask that question, like, what would, if you were stuck on a deserted island, what would you bring? Or if you're stuck in the desert, what would you bring? And why don't people ever ask for a big, huge Hummer truck if they're stuck in the desert? With, like, a bunch of food and a bunch of water and a bunch of gas in it. I think that would be the most logical answer. Karumi9Flamingo asks, who do you admire the most? I think that the person that I admire the most is definitely my mom. My mom is just amazing. She's so strong, and she's been through so much in her life. And when I think of her, I just, you know, I feel stronger because I just, if she can be the strong mother that she is, then I can be a strong person too. But anyways, if you guys don't mind, I have a special guest that I would like to bring in. And maybe or maybe not, you guys are freaking out right now too about that. But it happens to be my own very little sister, Madison. Yay! Come in, Madison. Hi, baby girl.
Hi.
What's going on?
Nothing.
I invited Madison to be a part of my live chat this morning, and here she is. Mm-hmm. So, do you want to help me with my questions?
Yes.
Okay, well, I wanted to ask you, how is it shooting Desperate Housewives this season?
Well, what's funny is I just went to work yesterday, and I had I had so much fun. I was so happy to be back, and I missed everyone so much.
That's awesome. What's it like working with Eva?
Eva is just the sweetest, awesomest person ever.
It's a true story. So, the DL Nation asks, if you were to dedicate one song to the Lovatics, which would it be and why? And I think it would be Skyscraper because it's really inspiring, right?
Mm-hmm.
What would you dedicate to them?
I think it would have to be Skyscraper.
Yeah, I agree. So tell me about your baby, Oliver. Is he potty trained yet? Does he sleep with you? He is being potty trained by my mom upstairs, and she's working her butt off to train two puppies at once because we got two dogs. And so I'm very thankful for her that she is potty training him right now. So he does not sleep with me at the moment, but once he gets potty trained, he'll be back into my house. I just am so busy that I don't have time to teach a dog how to be potty trained, and I've never done that in my life anyways. So I think it would be a full-time job, and luckily my mom's doing it for me, so yeah. Demi's Prince 820 asks, what is the one word that you would use to describe your fans? I think that it would be unbelievable. I mean, the support that you guys have given me is just so amazing and so incredible, and I'm just beyond blessed. So I love you, and you literally are tattooed on my skin for the rest of my life because I want to show you the support or how thankful I am for your support. So, Prince Ali Ababwa asks, what songs do you listen to when you work out? Lately, I have not been working out just because I wanted a break because it's summertime and I feel like I should be allowed to do that. So, taking a bit of a break from working out, it feels good. But when I did, I love listening to hip hop music. So, when I work out, I listen to hip hop. How often do you practice singing? Do you sing in the shower, car, airplane? That was from Aaron S. I sing everywhere. I literally sing in the shower, the car, An airplane would be kind of awkward unless I was flying private, and that's okay, because then you could sing as loud as you want. Nobody will stare at you weird. Which I actually have thrown a dance party one time on a plane, which is really cool. We blared Britney, and that was really fun. And I did sing very loud then, too. So I guess I do sing on airplanes. What is your new album like? P.S. We're all proud of you. War Nation 1 asks. Well, Madison's heard a little bit of it. What do you think it sounds like?
I think it is the coolest album I have ever heard.
There you go. That's all you need. That's all I need to hear. All right? No. It's definitely more pop, and it's not the pop rock feel anymore. It's got I'm showcasing my vocals a lot more like I did on Skyscraper, and I'm feeling really, really comfortable with what we have so far. So, yep. What's the best word to describe your little sister? Asks Big Mike. Thanks, Big Mike. And the best word to describe my little sister would be gorgeous.
Oh.
It's true. I think my little sister is the most beautiful person on the face of the planet, and I hope she realizes that too. Don't cry. It's true. I think that you are turning out to be such a beautiful young lady. Some of that Desperate Housewives sass right there. I see that. Okay. I don't know how to pronounce this name, but what happens when you see a fan crying? To be honest, it always kind of shocks me. Sometimes I get really taken back by it, because it's kind of a, when you think about it, it's kind of a weird thing to see someone crying because they met you, but ultimately it means the world to me. Like, it's so sweet, and I can't believe that, you know, people would cry just from seeing me in person. Like, I would do that over, like, Kelly Clarkson, but, like, I can't, like, imagine people doing that for me. So I'm always like, oh my God, why are you crying? What's wrong? What'd I do? Did I do something? Did I hit you with my bracelet? Or something? I don't know what happened. And so it always like freaks me out at first. And then I'm like, oh, I remember doing that for Kelly Clarkson. And that's so awesome. And I can't believe that people would feel that way towards me. So I guess that's what I do. Please send us a message for your fans in Japan. Hi. How's it going? I can't wait to see you guys. I want to go to Japan so bad, and I can't wait. Like, I really can't. And I've been praying for your country, and you guys are just so strong, and I am so inspired by all the courage that you guys have. So I can't wait to see you guys. What's your advice for someone who is scared to tell someone about their issues because they don't want attention? I would say definitely don't be afraid. Definitely don't be afraid. I think telling somebody was the best thing that I ever did, and getting help was the best decision that I ever made, because at the end of the day, I want to be healthy, and I want to be the best role model for my younger sister. And I want to, you know, I just, my, I don't know, I just want to be an inspiration to people, and I knew that I needed to get help for some issues, so definitely don't be afraid. Yeah. Oh, this is a question for Madison. Madison, what is your favorite thing about filming Desperate Housewives?
Well, my favorite thing about filming Desperate Housewives would have to be, it would probably have to be, like, getting your hair done and sitting in the chair, because you just feel like such a movie star when you're getting your hair done. And when they put a little makeup on you, and it's you feel like a movie star. It's pretty awesome.
It is pretty awesome. I love getting my hair done, and I love it when people play with my hair. Sometimes I make her play with my hair. I'm gonna ask them, will you scratch my head? Will you scratch my back? Will you play with my hair? Missy Lee 20 asks, do you plan on getting any more tattoos? No, maybe. I don't know. My parents are watching this, so. Sorry, Mom. No, I have enough for right now. I have a lot, so I'm gonna chill out on the ink. But you don't have any tattoos, do you?
No.
Good. No. Good. I was just making sure. Okay. Peyton Pironi asks, besides your album coming out, what other exciting news do you have? Well, I just announced when my album is going to be released, and I hope you guys remember it. September 20th, right? Yay. September 20th. So that's a huge announcement for me, and also maybe there's going to be more announcements coming soon where I can say how soon it'll be before I actually get back and be performing in front of you guys. So hopefully you guys, you know, hopefully I can announce that soon too. Would you rather win a Grammy or an Oscar? I would want to win a Grosker because I don't think that I can't choose one or the other. I don't know. I think winning a Grammy would be just the ultimate dream come true. But an Oscar would be unbelievable too. I mean, there's such pipe dreams that it's like, it's crazy, but I think a Grammy would be so cool. When is your next single coming out? I don't know. My next single is, well, we don't really know what it's going to be yet. We have a lot of songs. I've actually recorded about like 20-something songs, so we have to cut it down to fit the album, and then we'll choose the next single. So I don't know which one when it's going to be. When does your album come out? September 20th. Yes. So exactly a month after my birthday. Yay. Hi, Demi. What does your feather tattoo behind the ear mean? You know what? Doesn't mean anything. I was at Warped Tour and wanted to get a tattoo because they were given tattoos. And I was like, I'm doing it. And I got it. Didn't really think it through. Nope, back of a tour bus, didn't think it through. All right, what do you do when you're at home? I don't know, what do I do when I'm home? I watch a lot of TV.
Yeah.
Yeah, I hang out with my little sister.
Yeah, sometimes.
Sometimes.
Go hang out with you.
Sometimes she comes and hangs out with me.
Play basketball.
Yeah, we play basketball. I don't know, sometimes when we hang out, we play basketball and we watch TV. And play with the dogs a lot. Yeah. How did you get to the book A Piece of Cake? The book A Piece of Cake was actually just in Barnes & Noble's, and I was like, oh my god, sprinkles, I love sprinkles. So I picked up the book because it had sprinkles on the cover. So, yep, easy as that. And then I read the story, and obviously it was like the most inspiring story that I've ever read in a book, and I just was blown away. And I still really, really want to meet Cupcake Brown and tell her how like inspired I am by her and her story. What is your main goal that you would like to accomplish by the end of 2011? I know it sounds really cheesy, but I want to save someone's life. I feel like if my story has helped inspire people, I want to still inspire somebody. I know there's someone out there that'll hopefully listen to my story in Skyscraper and maybe it'll save them. That's my goal. And I won't know if it happened. Maybe I will. Maybe I'll find out. But, yeah, that's just my goal. What is your favorite movie? What's my favorite movie? I like scary movies, right?
I like scary movies.
Yeah. Scary movies. I don't know. Actually, I love Step Brothers and I Love You, Man. And those are comedies, so I don't know how I even got from scary movies to that. I don't know. I like a lot of movies. And Mean Girls, duh. Still one of the greatest movies ever.
Oh, yeah.
Which celebrity style do you like the most? I still love Nicole Richie's style. She has just the best style. And also Kim Kardashian and all of those sisters, Khloe and Kourtney, they have amazing style. And they're just gorgeous. And, yeah, so are you a Rihanna fan? And would you ever do a song with her? I think the question is, would Rihanna ever do a song with me? Yes, I am. I love her. She's amazing. And, yeah, that would be amazing. Wouldn't you do a song with Rihanna if she asked you? Yeah. That would be pretty rad. What is your favorite Southern Texan food? I'm going to have to go with chicken fried steak with mashed potatoes and gravy and country green beans, like the kind that comes in a can and does not taste, like, natural at all. So that's on a, and sweet iced tea. And now I'm craving Southern food. And I think I'm going to definitely not anywhere Southern in California tonight, so that's a bummer. And Tex-Mex. I love Tex-Mex. That's really good. My sisters and I have a band. Do you have a tip for us? How about you answer this one?
Well, obviously, I've never been in a band before.
You've been around me making music.
Yeah.
And you've seen a little bit of this lifestyle. I mean, do you have any advice for them? What if they wanted to be an actress?
Oh, being an actress is very fun. So, being an actress, if you wanted to be an actress and if you wanted to get far in the business, I would say, well, that's hard.
Yeah. I would say follow your dreams. Yeah. And if it's your passion, yeah, never give up. Mm-hmm. Frozen yogurt or ice cream? I'm going to have to go with frozen yogurt.
Oh, yeah.
So good. And I think it's healthier. But whether it's healthier or not, it's still so much better.
Yogurt sounds healthier than ice cream.
Yeah, I want frozen yogurt right now. That's right. Will you ever come to Boston? We have the best coffee, so that's a plus. Yes, I will. And I love coffee, so actually I could use some coffee right now. Yep. So I will definitely be there. And do you remember your first concert? Yes.
I remember.
Yes, my first concert was Hershey Park, and there was like 100 people there, and I was like, oh my god, there's so many people here, I'm so nervous. And it was so hot outside. I remember wearing like a red leather jacket, and I don't know why I wore it. It was like 100 degrees outside. But I performed, and my fans were amazing, and then I've seen some of my fans since then in my concerts, and I'm like, you were at my first show. So it was really cool. But anyways, thank you guys so much. Now I have a special treat for you guys. I'm actually going to play the Spanish version of Skyscraper. And here it is. I hope you guys like it. Thank you.
Lloré al cielo y en mis manos ve sus lágrimas caer. El silencio me hace daño, se acabó nuestro querer. La tristeza me castiga, se apropia de mi ser. Puedes llevar. Con el tiempo voy a olvidarme de ti. No te vas a dar cuenta que estoy sangrando aquí. Mis ventanas se han quebrado.